Right, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure for me to introduce to you the SLTV Starseries Season 10 right here on NIPTV. Man, it has been way too long since we've been doing anything on this channel, and I am sorry for that, but now that is about to change. There's going to be a lot more Counter-Strike coming up, and a lot of stuff in general happening here to the channel, so we'll see. I'm really excited to be, with you here for this for these games, but also for what's going to happen in the future. I can't reveal too much yet, but in the next couple of days, I think all will be a little bit clearer. Now, let me see if I can get Vendetta on the line here for Skype. If Skype decides to work, it's never really clear. You can never be sure. Hey, Ven.
Hey, how are you?
It seems to work a little bit. I think I'm going to turn your volume down just a second. But welcome to the show anyway. I'm glad you wanted to join me in spite of your Dota addiction.
Yeah, well, you know, you got to do what you got to do. CS comes first. And as you pointed out, it is only round robin.
It's not
the biggest styles. I think the highlight of the night probably it starts at 10 for me.
Oh, yeah. Tell me, why is that?
Well, there's this thing called the World Cup going on right now. I'm not sure if you actually followed it.
I don't know. What kind of sport are we talking about here?
It's you got this ball and you play with your feet. I think the Americans call it soccer.
Okay, well, all right then.
It's pretty outlandish. Not that well known. So it's kind of new. Hopefully it'll catch on.
Well, you know what? I did get a hint of this because you know, obviously I was in Berlin yesterday when Germany beat Brazil 7-1. Yeah. And unfortunately for us, we had made an agreement already to take a shot and a beer every time somebody scored. So stuff got out of hand really, really quickly. But that's all right. It was a really fun evening in Berlin, trust me. Semler's going to be joining us a little bit later. He only just got home. I only just got home from the airport as well. But I didn't want to leave these matches. So that's what it's down to. He's going to be joining us just as soon as he's finished eating his pizza, and then I think we'll be good to go. I think the audio level is cool now. I think I've turned you down a little bit. So guys, tell me in the chat if it's still too loud, then we'll try and switch it around. But otherwise, I think we're good. Are you on the server as well, then, with the Fnatic team?
Fnatic Berzerk. Yeah. And I'm also kind of lowered my my settings as well, because they keep resetting whenever I go on Skype for reason.
That does happen.
So yeah, a lot of stuff has happened since the last time we were actually casting a game. You've been in three different countries. A major has been announced. Brazil is no longer a football nation. Stuff has been happening.
And Counter-Strike has been updated. There's been a lot of changes to the wall banging, to different weapons. It's all a little bit crazy. We've added some new maps that might even be played at EMS. Who knows? Well, we'll see here. It's going to be the ninth round coming up, so it's been a while since I've said this, but welcome to NIPTV. I'm Anders, with me is Vendetta, and we are ready. Later, Semler's going to be joining us. It's going to be a best of one game, SLTV Star Series Season 10, Berserk versus Fnatic. Now, Ven, I mean, this new Fnatic lineup, I think that has to be the most exciting thing to talk about here for now.
Yeah, definitely. It's, as you said, a new lineup. Olafmeister and Krims have recently joined the Fnatic lineup. Double Walk and Schneider is no longer a part of Fnatic, which is a shame. Obviously, Fnatic has more or less been kind of like the buddy team of CSGO, I think it's fair to say. They've stuck together as one unit for the better part of CSGO's history until very recently. So, bit of a shame to see them go, but obviously you have to be excited to see players like Crimson Olafmeister stepping into Fnatic.
That's the thing, isn't it? I mean, I am sad that Schneider ended up, you know, having to be removed from Fnatic, because it didn't feel like he was really leaving out of his own free will. But, then on the other hand, you do really want to see Crimson Olafmeister in a really top team. So we will see. They're playing up against the German team Berserk with Asmo, Rack, Alex, Felix, and Solik. And they are some very cool guys, the Berserk guys. They funded, or was partly crowdfunded, partly funded their own way to DreamHack Summer, and they're some really friendly people. They're pretty good at Counter-Strike. They've been playing for a very long time, so we'll see if they can do something here against Fnatic. It's best of one game, so you never know. Starting off on the CT side, it's going to be Berserk, and already a very slow round coming out from Fnatic, it seems.
Yeah, they're just taking their time feeling things out, and for once, Fnatic hasn't actually opted to buy a lot of grenades. Only Flesha has really kitted himself out with grenades. So, not really sure what they opt to do. We're probably not going to see the same B take that we've seen in the past.
Oh, but a great opening coming out here. JW gets a second kill. Pronax picking up the first one. That does leave Rack and Solik alone towards the A bomb side. And now just Rack. and with a P2000, that's not going to happen. Man, that was a little bit unfortunate, because Berserk were in the right place, but they did not pick up a single kill yet.
Yeah, that definitely didn't go according to plan, and it didn't seem like whatever Fnatic had planned to do, that wasn't really necessary. You could see Flesha basically hung on to all of his nades, so whatever they wanted to do didn't really have to happen, because JW and Benibble, they basically just dissected the entire German team.
Saying there's a chance, maybe what they said is like, all right, you get the first pick off, and then we'll do the execute afterwards, and then they just never really got to it. They just killed everyone instead.
Yeah, you try to peek out and figure out where people are holding, if there's any wonky setups going on from the CT side, and you just happen to kill three people, so you just go with it.
Maybe that is what happened. Well, for now, we'll have to see if they can bounce back. They have actually picked up a Nova shotgun on Rack, and Alex also has body armor and the CZ 75, which has been nerfed, but only for when you're standing still and crouching. For when you're running, which I think is what you do most of the time, it's still pretty good.
Yeah, I can't really recall people standing still with the CZ.
Not much, right?
So, not really sure if that was the most effective nerf to the weapon, but I guess Valve has some spreadsheets and whatnot that they're knowledge from, yeah.
I bet they do. Well, we'll see. I mean, they've buffed some of the other pistols, so maybe it's all going to balance out at the end. Felix here does do a lot of damage, and Solik's going to pick up the kill. That's pretty good, but they need a little bit more, and there's the kill. Rack actually with the Nova shotgun. Asmo very nearly picking up a double there, and it's going to be Rack up in the apartments. He has to wait here. Crims is already spotting for him, and he's going to need backup from Alex, who's coming in. They could do this, but now that the bomb is down, it's going to be a little bit more tricky.
It's going to be rough, but already they've had a pretty decent eco. Sure, they invested a fair share of money into it, but gotten two kills so far, and if Rack is able to survive and Alex with his armor, I think they should be pretty happy about how that round turned out.
Yeah, they're looking pretty good. They even did some damage to Crims at the end, so actually if he's going to have to try and run away eventually, or he'll be fine. He'll run out towards the library, so no issue there in the middle. Alex seeing if he can get another pickoff. They really are trying to push the limits here, Berserk. See if they can get a little bit more out of it. But you're right, they do save a shotgun and a CZ 75 armor for the third round, which is coming up now. But Fnatic, they do look pretty confident overall, I'd say, at this point. No big hiccups.
Because even though it's a pretty decent eco from Berserk side, it doesn't mean that it was a horrible ending to their run for Fnatic on Fnatic's part. They can still keep themselves out pretty decently. Only Flesh is the one having to go with the Galil. Otherwise than that, they're completely fine.
Ooh, Chicken ate a grenade. Rack is right on the corner with the Nova. Is anyone going to flash him in? No, they don't have a flashbang, which is really annoying. That would be such a cheap investment for Berserk to actually make that peek on Banana. Instead, they just get grenaded back, and now, I don't know, the setup is just much less effective.
The element of surprise is kind of gone. It seemed like Berserk wanted to do a sudden peek onto the Fnatic members, but they stood a tiny bit too aggressively and got caught out.
Well, good pistol work coming out from Rack. It's a shame that Alex went down. They did swap up with the shotgun, and he very nearly got the kill on JW. Now backup is coming in, but it's going to be too late. Crims will take down Rack, and it should be a pretty easy round from here on out for Fnatic. I mean, what do you think, Vin? Actually, this is something I noticed watching some of the American teams when I was over at Texas doing the ESCA LAN finals. I realized a lot of the American teams, even in rounds when they finally eco, because they really don't eco a lot, the American teams, but when they do, they still buy, you know, a couple of smokes, a couple of flashbangs, and that seems to be a trend that's more and more popular, which Berserk maybe hasn't really picked up on yet.
Some teams do absolutely opt to pick up more grenades, because you could opt, or if you practiced a fair amount, or if you practice those certain things where you might want to do aggressive peeks with, let's say three people want to peek out mid, and then you do pop flash out into mid, maybe you catch one or two people off from Fnatic's side, and already there, you know, that's worth the investment of the flashbangs and all that. So I could definitely see why teams are doing it, and especially with the smokes, regarding how it's pretty much a death sentence to run through smokes with the way the smoke puffs work right now.
Yeah.
Definitely something you'd probably see more teams adapting to or going for.
We'll have to find out. Obviously, now we have the first gun round, the first actual rifle round coming out here from Berserk. They can afford not everything they wanted. I mean, Solik does have an AWP, so they definitely prioritize that, but it's without any kind of armor. So Pronax here, if he gets a body shot off, Solik won't be able to hit anything. He does do a bit of a peek there, quick shoulder peek from Pronax, and now they know there's an AWP, so that's some good information that Fnatic are going to put into their massive calculator that is Pronax. Asthma waiting up here at the end of the hallways towards the A bomb site, and this is shaping up to be an A execute so far, but it can still change. There's plenty of time left.
Seems fairly similar to what they did in the pistol round with Flush of just being the sole ranger towards the B bomb site. And there we go. JW with the entry frag onto Solik. And a bit of an issue for Berzerk right now is that, as you said, they didn't buy up fully. So they don't have that many nades, and now they're rotating over towards the B bomb site with Alexar only having a P90.
Oh, but that could be enough. If they run through this smoke, the P90 is going to take care of them. And he has another smoke and a Molotov as well. So he can actually hold it down here. They run through and Olofmeister very nearly goes down. He's going to get killed eventually. No, that's Pronax going down, in fact. So the bomb is still headed towards that B bomb site. Olofmeister is on 4 HP. They can actually retake this and they're going to have to go for it.
This is a really awkward situation to be in if you're Berzerk. Asmo's the only one with the death kit. Felix is kind of stuck behind the smoke here.
Oh, they spot one, and there's going to be the return kills immediately. Good round from JW, picking up two kills. It looked like they actually... they had him pretty close to the flowers here. When you come in that close to the orb, it seems like it should have been able to get a kill then. But ultimately, I mean, as you said a little bit earlier, Van, that leaving one guy with a P90 alone at the B-bomb site, maybe it wasn't enough after all.
A tiny bit hopeful. But Alex did buy quite a bit of time, and he actually managed to pick off one as well. So can't really fault that round on him. It did pretty much everything you could expect from a guy with a P90.
Yeah, true enough. And a little bit forward again, Krim's going to take down Alex. And I'm still not sure why, if they want to go forward like that, why they didn't just invest the $200 into a single flashbang. I feel like it'd be more effective.
It's definitely worth a try. You're giving yourself a better odds than just running out into four people, that's for sure.
Especially now that they've lost four rounds in a row, which means their consecutive round loss bonus is ramping up. They could afford to invest the $200 into it. But Smoke's going to go off really traditional smoke towards the CT spawn. Solik holding on one side. Felix now alone inside the bomb site towards Oranges. And actually right through the smoke. Look at that. Solik picks off one. And Felix misses an easy shot. He's going to go down. That was a big screw up on Felix's part, unfortunately. Oh man, he could have got a bunch of kills, at least one, but probably two then.
Guess that was some sort of a karma, seeing how Solik just completely trashed Krims through the smoke, with no apparent reason. That was just random shooting through the smoke. At least I couldn't hear any sounds coming out from Krims, so that was pretty weird. In any case, five to nothing in favor of Fnatic. So far, not really anything special happening from Fnatic side. They've just won the pistol and the first anti-ecos and the first buy round. So this is where Berzerk really has to step up and start to get some rounds on the board.
Yeah, kind of is now or never. This is obviously a CT-sided map, as most people already know. So kind of is about time.
And this is weird. Again, Alexar has opted to go for a P90, even though he could have afforded to buy a Colt.
So maybe it's not, you know, a question of economy. It's just a, you know, they just prefer that
personal
weapon,
preference.
Maybe.
Yeah. But that does not make sense to me. That does not make sense on any level. But if he makes it work, then all the more power to him. But this does not seem like something you should opt for.
No, I'm not 100% sure I agree either, but we'll see if it's going to be effective. So far, some great openings coming from Berserk. Solik with the 1 AWP shot. He's looking for one more. He's going to get it as well. Pronax goes down. Very good work coming out from the German team. And it is about time, as we said. It's kind of now or never. So the rest of Fnatic, Crimson Flusher, I mean, they are moving over here. And I guess best case scenario for them right now is getting a bunch of rifles away from Berserk so that they don't come out of this with a flawless round.
Hopefully, they'll be able to take out the P90. they could very well get a bomb plant here, and who knows, from there on out, it's a 2v3 in a favorable position for the T's.
Oh, are you kidding me? Actually, that P90, even that close, it didn't stand up to Krim's AWP. Felix was there to pick it up, so they only lose the P90. And now the big question is, we're all looking at Alex now, you know, is he gonna rebuy it?
Now Felix has a P90. Oh, Felix dropped a P90 for him.
Okay, then.
This is weird. There's no other word for it, and it hasn't worked out too well so far, so I'm not really sure why they continue to kit him out with a P90.
I don't know. Well, I'm curious. I mean, this must have worked out at some point during practice or something else so that they decided to keep doing it. But it does seem a little bit strange. Now, this is a slight variation from Fnatic. This time, they actually don't have anyone towards Banana, though Pronax is holding it to make sure they don't get backstabbed. But they're not making any noise at B. So, Berserk should... I mean, they have three people here. They should have a pretty good defense. Oh, are they going to boost up here? Oh, please. JW peeks up, and Solik still gets the kill. JW missed the shot, but that was such a cool plan. I love seeing that.
That was a really cool idea. I probably would have preferred seeing JW with the AWP there in that situation.
Yeah.
Even though you do get the benefit with the element of surprise, still, just needing that one shot makes this all the more easier, because they knew Solik was going to pick that corner.
Yeah, it feels... I mean, but even without the orb, it seems like he should have been able to get that shot. Now he's waiting for Olofmeister to maybe peek up while the rest of the team is making their way towards Archway, where actually Felix is just falling back. So, a little bit unfortunate timing, but look at the time, the clock here, man. 30 seconds for Fnatic. They've got to move. They are going to move. Solik takes down the bomb and misses the next shot. Now it's just one guy in pit holding this A bomb site. He's going to take down Olof, but the bomb plant should happen here. But they're not in good positions, Fnatic. Once inside, if Pronax can make it out alive, he might be able to get in a slightly better position. He's waiting right here by the car. Rack almost goes down. It's a shot from Flusher. It's back into a 2-on-2 now, a 1-on-2 for Flusher. He's going to have to come up with an ace here to win the round. He's going to get another kill. That's now a quad. He's looking for Felix. Time is running out. He's going to have to go for it. And out of bullets as well, he gets the time to reload. Felix running up close, and Flusher spraying and gets the headshot right through the box. And that is an ace from Flusher. Man.
Bit of a chaotic round.
What happened there?
Well, as you said, the Fnatic were running down on time, but luckily for them, their original plan was just to really wrap around the A bomb site. So they weren't really that pressed for time. I guess the hitch in the road was the fact that Rack did survive in pit for that long, and that could have caused troubles, but I'm not really sure what Alex R was doing during that retake, because he more or less just ran into the bomb site without any sort of coverage or help from anyone on his team and gave away the advantage that Berserk had.
Yeah, it felt like he ran in to try and save Rack, but in a really awkward way, because they just couldn't have helped each other in that situation. Maybe there was some communication issue. This time, a really good start, actually. Solik took the duel against AW in the middle, and this is a glass cannon AWP on Solik. He doesn't have any body armor, so it's pretty good that he came out on top. That should give Berserk a really good position, but now... this is a little bit strange to me. They have a one-man advantage, and they still elect to put Alex alone over here at the B-bomb site. That's, you know, something you do normally if you're a man down and you want to keep the A-bomb site really secure.
Yeah, I think Berserk might be a tiny bit tilted due to the fact that Fnatic have been going heavily towards that A-bomb site. But...
oh, Felix, can he not hear him? There it goes. Olofmeister does go down. And now, Alex, let's see. Third time is the charm. He's waiting right here. He's got the FAMAS out there running right past him in the smoke. They have no idea that he's here. This is some really cool play. Look at Alex. And now, well, they're going to try for the bomb plant. But, surprise, bomb is down. And now, 15 seconds left. Very, very patient play coming out from Alex. And this should be around. No problem now for Berserk. Pronax is alone. He's out of time. He's going to go down. And a well-deserved double kill for Alex. Very cool play.
Absolutely. That's one of those situations where you have to remain cool and have that extra amount of patience to really pull that off. So really well done, because a lot of people would get too eager when they hear that many footsteps to just go for the first kill and hope that you can hide away in the smoke after that first kill. I guess Fnatic could have taken more advantage of it though and actually gone for the plant earlier, but it didn't really play out for them in this round.
Not this time around. That puts us into the ninth round, where JW's the only one to pick up an AK and body armor, and I guess he had the money to equalize. Yeah, he did, so he still has 2200. But otherwise, it's mainly Eco Olofmeister. Oh, that was so cool. He just walked up calmly, casually. He took down Asmo. Did he steal the gun?
I don't think he did.
Oh, no. So he couldn't reach it. But still, getting one rifle away is a pretty good start.
Not too shabby at all. Still going to be pretty tough for Fnatic to actually get onto a bombsite right now because, well, as you can see, Felix is posted up towards Arch, Solik is there to back him up, and Rack does have a pretty good position for holding off an eco round. I guess a lot of it comes down to really if JW is able to pick off people. You can see Fnatic are basically just posturing up, waiting for JW to arrive towards that A bombsite and see if he's able to pick one more off.
Well, in that case, let's follow the man with the AK, see if he can get something done. Already does some pretty good damage to a teammate, which is not exactly ideal. Solid takes one more member of Fnatic out. And now, let's see, the one AK, can he do anything? I mean, he's running out of teammates, and now he's very nearly alone. So maybe he's a little bit too late to the party. It seems like it's actually all of my stuff they have to rely on. He picks up the one kill, takes the rifle, but Alex hears it, and he's just going to be waiting, shooting him in the back. And JW alone takes down the one, now has two more to go with 10 seconds. It's no longer possible, unfortunately. He's going to take down the one. They just have to not challenge him here, and they'll be fine. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, he's around the corner. Oh my god, that was very close to him getting a shot on Alex, but it doesn't follow through. And, I mean, it's still a fantastic eco round from Fnatic either way.
Yeah, pretty good eco round from Fnatic, no doubt. And I probably would have liked to see Fnatic play it even more slow, which sounds kind of silly when they actually ran out of time. But they lost so many with JW not really having the opportunity to pick people off. You saw Solid was waiting on the corner of quad, back at quad there, basically just waiting for people to walk into sight. And as soon as he got one of the guys without a gun, he ran off, which is a smart thing to do from Solid's side, but it leaves JW in an awkward situation where he has to commit too hard, really, to actually get a frag, and makes it so hard for Fnatic to actually get that opening they need.
Yeah, well, maybe they'll get it this time. I mean, they already have the 6 rounds, so I think in terms of playing on Inferno, 6 rounds is basically enough for the terrorist side. I think anything more right now is just going to be topping. Solik trying to run away, but Olofmeister had already crept up very closely towards the corner of Arch. Then now it's going to be Felix trying to hold Archway alone with a FAMAS against 4 incoming terrorists. And over at the B bomb site, Alex is about to be in a weird sandwich. He does. No, actually, Felix picked up that one kill. Alex alone, and he's getting backstabbed any second now.
And Krims is also staying back in library, so Rack has really no easy way to actually get towards that B bomb site at all.
Look at Flusher and Alex here, right up beside the cart, and it's going to be Flusher coming out on top, and that's it. Fnatic, look at the patient play coming out from them right here. They are just very, they realize that there's got to be somebody else in B, so they waited slowly, even though they had basically a 4-on-1 situation in that bomb site. They just still waited, so that's pretty admirable. Now it's going to be a 1-on-3 here, Rack trying to save an AK, but already it's Crims on the hunt.
Crims is right around in the right neighborhood. I'm not really sure if you could hear Rack scoping up. He might have done that, actually.
Did he? He's certainly walking the right way, so you might be right. Maybe he has got an idea. And there it is. Rack goes down. No AWP saved, and a very good round from Fnatic. Puts them now 7-3. I mean, what is it? What can Berserk do at this point? Is it something with their setup? Do you think they're holding too passively? Do they need to throw in some more aggressive moves here?
It's definitely something they could try out, because right now their setup isn't working at all. And it's a bit worrying for them as well, because they have been opting to go with 4 people towards that A-bomb site, with Felix playing passively in Speedway and Solik on the corner of Arch. And that hasn't been working out really too well for them. And now Fnatic are really taking advantage of that as well. And you can see how open it was for them towards that B-bomb site once they decided to split. And I don't really know, because Berserk are already bolstering up the weak points of their map, but they're still not able to close Fnatic down and denying them entrance.
Yeah, it's just not working out that well at all. And it might also just be the case that they're getting a little bit outgunned at this point. JW and Flusher, and actually everyone on Fnatic right now, has got a decent amount of kills, so they've got nobody lacking far behind. Rack is on a pretty cool mission here. If only he had a rifle, this would be such a great position. With the P250, it's not going to be as easy, but he's still going to try. He's walking up right in the middle of the whole Fnatic team, and now it's down to timing. Can he pick somebody off? He knows where Olofmeister is now. He's going to walk out, look the other way, get spotted, and in turn, oh no. Oh, what? Solid and Rack! 2 for Rack, 1 for Solik. Actually, incredible work here with the pistol. And I think Fnatic must have lined up perfectly. Rack picks up another one. That's now a triple. Sensational play indeed. Now it's going to be down to Flusher here. 1-on-4, looking for the kill. He's going to get the one, but this is obviously a big blow to Fnatic here in the 11th round.
Even if this round doesn't go Berserk's way, which it should by now, it's still a great eco. That looked so much like one of those rounds where he should have gotten 3. That's what everyone's gonna type on the forums, and somehow it worked out.
Oh, but look at Flusher. He's not done yet. They're lined up right in front of him. He's spraying through. He's not guessing the right angle. Felix defusing. He's holding it down, and Flusher goes down. It's Rack with the quad kill, and Felix nerves of steel just sitting right in that smoke trying to defuse, and he does get it home. So, I mean, one bullet on either player here, and that would have been it. But finally, and in Fnatic, or sorry, Berserk, they need to make this 8-7 at the very least to try and have a chance here in this game still.
Yeah, I think they definitely need to win the CT side. It's already a pretty rough result for them. Although I think it's safe to say that Fnatic are favorites, even though they have a pretty new lineup. I would put Fnatic as being the favorite to win this.
Yes, I agree.
So, sure, losing, for instance, 7 or 8 on the CT side isn't optimal, but it's not the worst result in the world versus a team like Fnatic.
They might be happy if they can get that far. And with that kind of opening from Solik, it is a little bit closer. Rack is going to get smoked off here, and Fnatic creeping over towards Library and Little Pit. JW is right on the edge, but they can't really see each other. I think Rack, yeah, he must have spotted one jumping by, and then JW comes back. He had an inkling as well. Now they're going to go towards the B bomb side, but I love the fact that they've kept Olaf Meister here. Anyone tries to rotate out of this A bomb side, they're really going to lose a play. He walks up, takes down Solik, and now if they can just kill Felix or Alex, it's going to be a pretty good push here, but they're just waiting right now.
Oh, JW is doing the sneaky thing here.
Gets the one kill, and then Alex comes in. He goes down to Flusher, and it's going to be all on Asmo in the pit here, and he's actually running, making a lot of noise. Olaf Meister not hesitating to get that headshot, and that was a very cool... I mean, this is, I think, where Pronax is probably the strongest as an in-game leader, in my opinion. It's not so much doing the really incredible executes, although Fnatic do have some cool executes, but I think the mid-round calling is where Pronax does pretty well.
Yeah, he's able to read his opponents really well, and it's... Well, it's really easy for us to see because we have an overview map and can basically see every viewpoint possible. But yeah. The fact that they know that Arch is a bit of a weak link, even when Solik is getting entry cracked, which he has done pretty well, they're still able to abuse the fact that they somewhat know how Berserk are holding this Arch site. So they're able to take small advantages everywhere whenever they decide to push up towards an archway.
Some good pistol kills coming in this round from Berserk, but I'm not sure it's going to be enough. The bomb will go down, and they have saved a couple of AKs, but going for the retake is going to be very tricky. Unless they can pick up his next kill, and they won't. It's going to be Rack alone. 1-on-3 goes for the one kill here. Bomb is down, and there's a Molotov to try and keep him back. He's now fighting it out with JW towards the coils, and I think Rack... Okay, that grenade was pretty much perfect.
He should have run, though. As soon as that Molotov goes down, you should just... come to terms with the fact that you're not going to defuse that bomb anytime soon.
I definitely agree, But, you know, I guess at this point, Berserk realized that giving Fnatic 9 rounds is... It could really quickly spiral. Yeah, you know.
It's not the best thing in the world.
You do just want to be a hero, and it's a best-of-one game as well, so it's all or nothing here. Mm-hmm. And I believe NIP aren't even playing in this this season SLTV, are they?
I don't think they are.
No, I don't think they are. So Fnatic could definitely be a contender to win the whole thing, in fact. I mean, Fnatic VODS Pro, especially with this new lineup, I'm pretty excited because there was something very broken about the former Fnatic lineup, whatever it was. Something was not working.
I think it might be a tad harsh to say very broken. That was still a very, very good team, but...
Yeah.
They seem to be... going in a downward spiral, or their trajectory wasn't looking up as of late.
Yeah,
I guess is the nicest way I can put it.
That is a pretty nice way of putting it. I appreciate that. Oh, Rack gets the one kill. That flash failed. The second one does work a little bit better, but not well enough to blind JW. Now, this is all a fake from Fnatic. They are making a lot of noise towards Archway. They pick up the one kill or trade. One for one, as we might say. And then inside the B-bomb site, that leaves Felix alone. And any minute now, it's going to unfold. Alex goes down, and it's another split coming out here. Not hugely elaborate from Fnatic, but it's pretty a Felix. He's going to have to come up huge here with just the M4A1. One Molotov and some body armor and a kit. Already one grenade raining in. They're checking the corner here. Flusher comes in and jumps and still gets the headshot.
And it feels like a lot of these rounds are playing out the same way over and over. Someone from Berserk gets the opening frag of the round. Fnatic responds, ends up going archway, depending on how many frags they actually get in archway and how many people Berserk opt to rotate around towards archway, decides whether or not they just wrap around the A site or split B. And it's pretty much ending up with Fnatic winning the round each and every time.
It definitely feels like it, and Solik misses that no scope as well, so no saving the AWP either. Jets JW's turn to pick up a triple kill. He's also topping the scoreboard right now with 17, 3, and 6, which has to be considered a pretty good ratio.
not too shabby.
That brings us to the 15th round, and I don't know. I mean, this is what it's like playing in a league, right, Ben? Sometimes you get matched up against teams that are just better than you, basically. I think that's what we're seeing here.
Yeah, absolutely. And it could also be on the one team's favorite map and your least favorite map. All those things could happen. True. So wouldn't read too much far into this, but we would expect Fnatic to win this game, I think, regardless of map.
Yeah, it seems like it's a pretty good bet. And I think the odds on CSGO Lounge were pretty heavily stacked in favor of Fnatic.
Yeah. We've seen Berserk upset several top teams previously, so who knows? I wouldn't be too surprised if Berserk went on a run on the T side and all of a sudden got 7 rounds in a row, because that's a Berserk-like thing to do.
Yeah, we'll see. So far, I'm just looking forward to Asmo and the... Oh, he peaks a little bit early, and JW takes down Alex, so no action at all, unfortunately, for Berserk here in the final round of the first half. Solik is going to smoke off inside the bomb site and then try and wait in the corner, which is a pretty cool idea. But Fnatic are taking it slowly. They're really not, they're really not panicking at all. Just waiting it out. JW takes one more. That's now a double for him, and they are looking for Solik. They realize he's in here. So a very smart play from Fnatic.
This is your time, Felix.
Yeah, make it happen. The shotgun. Well, he's revealed himself, and Scrims will take him down. So 11-4 for the first half on the terrorist side for Fnatic. Yeah, that is pretty one-sided.
It is. I do have to say that, though, Berserk did have quite a few rounds that they potentially could have gotten, but Fnatic, as you said, they're doing things so slowly and methodically. They're taking their time, playing at a really safe pace. So they're not really vulnerable to making these silly mistakes that could potentially lose them the round. They did lose versus one eco, but I think that was more up to Rack having the stars align, getting those two kills.
Yeah.
I think it was more of that than anything else. But I like what Fnatic are doing. They're playing this smart.
They are playing it smart. You know, especially playing against a lesser opponent. I feel like some teams do really quickly degenerate into just frag hunting and doing whatever they feel like.
Like
Fnatic have, even in positions when they've been one or two people up, where they had a great advantage, where you could forgive one of them for looking for some easy kills, they've actually kept it pretty cool, and that's important right now. So maybe that's some credit going towards Devilwalk here, who's obviously the coach now. And I noticed he was in the chat earlier as well. If you're just joining us, then welcome to the stream. It's NIPTV. I'm Anders. With me is Vendetta, and we're watching the SLTV Star Series Season 10. It's first game here of the evening. It's going to be 4 more games after this, and it will be fun night, I hope. Some great games coming up later on as well. Second half here, obviously pistol round, the most important for a Berserk. Fnatic can easily afford to lose a pistol round, although they probably don't want to. JW's gonna fall back. Look at the stack coming out here. I mean, Fnatic, how could they know that actually the German team is headed this way?
Oh, this is cheeky.
This is almost a little bit suspicious. It's like, have they been studying demos from Berserk? JW flashed, runs back, still gets a headshot. Crims has flashed as well, and he's actually not going to get the killer. Will be flusher. Bomb trying to be planted right in front of the players inside here, but this is not exactly good enough. They've already lost way too many people. Solid goes down. Now Rack alone, 1-on-4. He's going to get taken care of. That was Berserk trying to use Fnatic's own strategy against them.
Yeah, I was about to say that was Berserk trying to Fnatic.
Yeah.
Didn't really work out. It seemed like Fnatic definitely knows what their weak points to their own strats are.
Yeah, definitely. But I'm still curious about how the hell they knew to put 4 people here. 3? Actually, even if they had put 3 people here, I would have been a little bit suspicious because it's a pistol round. But 4 is definitely uncommon. They did have one guy over at the apartment spotting towards second mid. So I guess as long as he doesn't see anyone, there is actually a pretty good chance no one's going to be coming A. But I still think it's a pretty crazy risk. Now they're going to be running down, and Olofmeister picks off 3 really quickly, pistols out, and it's going to be an ace. No problem. Grenade, M4A1, and then the USPS. He takes care of business.
That was, yeah, Felix, giving Olofmeister credit.
Sick ace bro with an O at the end. I like the detail.
So no hard feelings between the teams, at least. So that's good. Eco Cobra.
Oh yeah, the Eco Cobra. I actually promised somebody that we'd try and revive that term again, so apparently that's a very old Counter-Strike term.
That's...
Please. I'm sorry to interrupt you, but Felix spraying right through onto Pronax. That did make me a little bit happy. Now JW pretty aggressively up here is going to try and run back, and he will be successful at that at least. But that was a cool wall bang. Very good.
It's an absolute very good start, and a very much needed start for Berzerk. Not a lot of things have really been going their way so far. Now it's more down to how they're able to execute. They're pretty far spread out, but if they're able to get Krems here through the smoke, this could be an opening for B.
That'd be a really big opening, especially as Olofmeister is just making his way on towards Archway. He's still pretty close by, but you've got to respect that if he comes back in, that passage will be smoked off and he's going to have to go through construction instead. So yeah, Krems is pretty much the man in B right now.
Yeah, a bit of an issue for Berzerk right now is that the fact that they only have one smoke, so they have to opt to either smoke off spawn or coil slash ruins area.
And they
they're going to opt to smoke off spawn, which is...
But Olofmeister actually landed on the right side of the smoke. He just ran through Krims, going to take down the first player. Flusher with a kill. Krims raiding on the corner. He takes one more with him, and very nearly a third one. And then Olofmeister just strolls in casually, pick up the last two kills, and it will be 14-4 here with Olofmeister now chasing down JW for the top frags here. 20-20 on each player.
Yeah, that was a... For having one smoke in the team, that's not the smoke you should throw.
No.
That's all I can say, because that landed behind the, or
towards
at the back of the car. Yeah,
yeah,
exactly. And that's far too far behind, to put it really awkwardly. Olofmeister's picked up an AWP right now, and he's going to go to town on the German team.
He really is, right? Just no fear at all. And this is where... they are actually losing some players here. Felix with some great headshots with the Deagle, which is also recently buffed. Still, still a pretty good pistol. And Felix, not done yet. In a one-on-one, be very impressed if he could do this. Grenade's going to take him down to 14 HP. That was a perfect nade nearly from Pronax. But there's more than a minute left.
There is, and Pronax might actually get caught off guard here.
Oh... peekaboo, but no, Pronax is a little bit too soon. If Felix hadn't scoped then, he would have been able to see Pronax. That's incredibly unfortunate. Still very cool play from Felix. That was a nice round. But I think actually that round is the sort of round I was talking about earlier, where Fnatic start to get a little bit too giddy. They just want the kills now.
Exactly. We're up against an eco. They've been mauling over Berserk pretty much the entire game, and they want to have some fun with it.
Exactly.
I wouldn't be too surprised if Olofmeister and JW are now having an internal battle of who can come out on top.
And this is where you need Devilhawk to be the guy with the, you know, leashes on them.
The voice of reason.
Exactly, telling them, don't do it, don't throw the game away.
At least they've secured the tie, I guess, so they have the opportunity to throw away 10 more potential rounds before they really have to hunker down.
That is a lot. Well, Pronax doesn't mess around, picks up the first kill there on Rack, although it was a little bit messy. I think he overpeaked a little bit on that corner, but it's going to be all right. They realize there's people in the apartment still, and also in the middle, so I think right now Fnatic have a very good idea about what's going on. And JW in the middle takes the one kill now. Berserker trying to push through, but it's not going to be enough here. It's a 2-on-4 situation. Alex, the only guy left now, and he goes down. Krims with the last two kills, and a 16-4 victory for Fnatic. Wow.
Pretty impressive. Was that the first official game Fnatic has played with the new
I think
lineup?
They played one more here at the SLTV Starseries, but I haven't been you know, too much at home, so it's been a little bit difficult to keep up. But we'll see.
This is true.
I think they had another one in between. But that is it, ladies and gentlemen. That's the first game of the evening done with. This next game coming up, it's actually almost going to get worse for Berserk because they're playing Virtus Pro. Not exactly a nice switch up. One, you've just been playing Fnatic, now you're playing Virtus Pro next. That's